Hey, Nick here with Zona Camp and Hike. Just wanted to go over some basic sleeping bag information because your sleep system could be one of the most critical pieces of your base camp, your weekend hike, or your through hike, depending on what's going on. So to kind of go over some basic sleeping bag information, I wanted to bring up some that we have that we use in our variety of camping and as we've upgraded during time. So the first I'd like to go over with is a Coleman. Here I have a Coleman Alpine 50 degree sleeping bag. Nice thing about Coleman, of course, it's well known. Everyone can find a Coleman product at an outdoor store, your local Wally World store, anywhere. So Coleman offers great products for a great price for your average weekend camper, family camping, base camp setup. Here we have this red Coleman Alpine, 50 degrees. 50 degree is considered a comfort level. This is where you're most comfortable at, not a minimum degree or where you'll survive at. With the 50 degree comfort level, the 40 degree minimum temperature that you can survive at, this Coleman full-size sleeping bag is great for a base camp, family camp, car camping, something that you can roll up easily and not have to worry about compact size or weight. This one here again can fit your average person up to 5'11". I'm 5'7", 5'6 and a half, 5'6", I don't know, something like that. I fit in here great with the family. And the nice thing about these full-size sleeping bags is, of course, they are rectangular, great box space here at the bottom for your feet, for roaming. Good pillow coverage on the front and the inside here. Coleman has a nice snagless zipper. It says snagless, but in reality, I still have it on a hard time zipping things up. They get snagged every once in a while. However, again, inside this nice Coleman sleeping bag, it's cozy and warm. It just feels fluffy on the inside. A little pocket you can put stuff. I never do. I've never have. Another nice, neat feature about a standard sleeping bag is they can be zipped together. When I do our family camping trip, my wife likes to snuggle nice and close, and we can put two sleeping bags together, have a queen size sleeping bag on either an air mattress or a pair of cots. So there are some great advantages to having a full size sleeping bag. It doesn't compact up very small. It doesn't, oh, look at, see, it just kind of snagged right now. There we go. It doesn't get compact. It's not very small and it's not very lightweight. So again, not recommended for a backpacking trip, not recommended for a weekend warrior, such as a 2-day trip if you're backpacking through, or definitely not through hike. But it does have some neat features when putting the Coleman sleeping bag together. When you roll it up, this particular model has a few little notches here that can be used to keep it from moving. When I say moving during your roll up, so it might be a little hard to see, but if you can see here, I'm gonna tee in a hole, grab this, open it up, and you kind of roll it in. Same thing here on the end, grab it and kind of roll it in. I'm getting there, I'm getting there. I promise I'm getting there. And then when you go to roll it, it does have these neat hooks and loops on either end. Here, here, so you can wrap it and roll it. I'll do a quick roll. And what's nice is you'll see that it doesn't spread apart as you roll because it's hooked in. Again, it's not very compact. It's not meant for that backpacking weekend type. It's not meant for the through hiker. It's meant for a base camp. It's meant for your family to go out and enjoy and keep your sleep system simple and not complicated. This style here. Little hooks, like so. Then it's all set, ready to go in the bag. And it goes in a nice little pull bag here. It's got a nice wide mouth. Again, it's not always the simplest process to bag a sleeping bag, but the more practice you have, the better it can become. Just with any base camp, hopefully you've got some time and to relax and chill. Not super imperative for time to move out, but with a wide mouth and a bit of the pushing in and out, you can kind of get it in. All right, you get the drift. When it's all said and done, it's all packed up nice and neat like this. Again, that's the Coleman Alpine. You can find these ones here at your local Walmart, Wally World, sporting goods store. You can find something simple there. Moving on. From a standard rectangular box type of sleeping bag, these next three are the mommy sleeping bags. A little more progressive towards the weekend camp, section hike, through hiking. This one here is my first one. On the top is the Marimont Aspen 55. Marimont Aspen is a very lightweight, very thin sleeping bag designed for warmer temperatures, especially for somewhere here like I'm living in the southern Arizona. So our summer times and daytimes can get up to 100, 110, 120 in our evenings and nighttimes, a low of 65 degrees. Here at a comfort level, well, a survival level with the Aspen 55, we can sleep comfortably at 60, 65 degrees. Very lightweight, comes in at about 24 ounces. And compact, very, very small, so it's easy to keep with you. Again, if you're weekend, not gonna be cold, you don't have to worry about the temperature dropping too drastically. This is a great bag to have, something of this nature, this mummy sleeping bag, to allow you to have lightweight, because if you're backpacking or hiking during a hot time or a higher, warmer temperature, you definitely want to keep your pack as light as possible. Therefore, you're not consuming so much calories during the course of the day and sweating so much. So here, this one can pack up very nice and small. As you can see here, much smaller than your standard base camp sleeping bag. Again, about 24 ounces, very thin, very lightweight. I like it. Now these zippers, you know, they don't snag as often. They do still now and again, but not as often. It's not a big particular moment here for snagging on it, but the nice thing is that it's size and it's lightweight. The Marimont Aspen 55. I do believe this has been discontinued, no longer available, but this one has provided some great flexibility for me and lightweight, especially when it comes to camping. And moving on. The next one I have is my upgraded version from this green one here. These next two bags I picked up for my section hiking for the Arizona Trail, specifically to keep it nice and warm. Here in Arizona, sometimes depending in where you're at, because they're diversified in our area, we can have this phenomenon where even though during the day it's warm, we have a sudden drop in temperature. And if you're out in a rural area, those areas can get, you know, into the 30s, even though during the day can be 80s or 90s. So it's a huge, huge swing at night with a quick drop in temperature. So it is important to have a nice warm sleeping bag when you're out through hiking. Just again, be aware of your environment, understand where you're hiking, and choose that right bag. However, here I've got the Cosmic Kelty 20 degree. This one is a 550-pound sleeping bag, very lightweight, right around 2 pounds. Survival level at 20 degrees, comfort probably right around 30. It's so far done me quite well. It does compact, very nice and neat. And with this stuff sack, it comes off pretty small. The Cosmic Kelty has a nice, again, striving for a snagless zipper. Does have these in here, stitching to help alleviate some of that snag when you're zipping up and down. So it does have that little added feel to it. With this weight, you can get compact, nice and neat. Let's take a moment. Let's see how we can stuff this in. And let's see how this big sleeping bag can get into this small sleeping bag. It's a nice thing about a down is that it can get really small and still provide a great deal of warmth. But the catch on that is you don't want to get it wet. Once you start getting a down sleeping bag wet, it does lose a lot of its ability to keep you warm, and it does take quite some time to dry. So keeping it dry is very important. Disappear for a minute. Getting on the ground, kind of get a better stuff up from the angle from where I'm sitting or standing. There we go. Nice small stuff sack. Kelty Cosmic Down. It's nice and neat and small. Little comparison to the Marimont. Definitely a little bit bigger in size compared to this ultra lightweight 55 degrees, but 20 degree Fahrenheit for a down sleeping bag, right around 2 pounds. Great perspective to have. Moving on to my first sleeping bag that I picked up for our section hiking is the Kelty Tuck. Kelty Tuck's got a few neat, nifty features on it. Now, this is a synthetic sleeping bag. It is not a down sleeping bag. Oh, I found my little chart. Hey, I was right. My Kelty Cosmic is 2 pounds and 10 ounces. Hey. Anyways, so, the Kelty Tuck has a different little perspective on it. It's got a nice small head here rather than a wider one. And it does have two zippers here, so you can actually unzip the bottom to get your feet out to be nice and cool. And of course, the top zipper by the head here. Again, a little bit different as far as their proprietary zipper system. They have a little poof bag here with some stitching to kind of keep from getting stuck. Not the same as the Cosmic Kelty, but it does the same job. Now, this one's a bit heavier. This one's weighing, coming in right around 3 pounds, synthetic sleeping bag, and it doesn't get as small as the Cosmic Kelty, but it offered great warmth and nice and cozy. It was big and fluffy. The feet box here, unlike the Cosmic version, is a bit fluffier, a bit more squared. We have a women's version here on the right-hand side. And this one here has a larger foot box. It's a bit smaller for women. And it's a bit poofier, allows them to be a little warmer, a little more comfortable. One of those things to think about as well with sleeping bags, as I touched on, is having the appropriate bag for the appropriate person. Your sleep system is one of the most important aspects when you're out camping or hiking, base camp. You always want to get a good night's sleep. You always want to be warm and toasty and cozy and comfortable and wake up and feeling refreshed and ready for the next day. But back onto the tuck here, it's again synthetic. It's got a nice head box, as I mentioned, smaller, square, so it's a little harder to put a pillow in there. But if you have a small pillow or a small air pillow, you can kind of get it, stuff it in, keeps it nice and tight. And then the nice thing about this though is that it really wraps around your face nice and tight. So when you have that cold morning or on your base camp and you want to sit back and relax and just keep your head nice and toasty, this definitely does the job. Again, each sleeping bag's a little different perspective. Each one offers something amazing. Let's see how small we can get this one. And this one here actually has some compression straps on it, which kind of tells you that it's not gonna get super small to begin with, that you've got to have something in addition to provide that compression. Kind of like the Marimont here has compression straps. Now, the nice thing about this one is it's already small and light, but you can make it even that much smaller with these compression straps. So, well done, Marimont, for making something small, light, but adding additional compression. Well, let's see if we can get the Kelty tuck in its little bag, because I haven't put it in the bag in a while. I usually just stuff it in my pack, and maybe that's something I'll go over later. But for this guy, cue the music and cue the speed up. So here we have the Kelty tuck wrapped up in this little bag, followed by the Cosmic Down. You can see, again, the sizing difference, which you can't really see is the weight. But with it being compressed like this, we can actually do a little weight test. We're at 0, 3 pounds, 8 ounces with its compression sack. I don't usually bring the compression sack with the tuck or when I had to use the tuck, so right around 3 pounds. Here we go. Kelty tuck, synthetic sleeping bag in its compression sack. Let's clear this. We're at 0, and let's see the Cosmic Down. 2 pounds and 2.5 pounds, 2.55. Kelty Cosmic, 550 down sleeping bag. Marimont Aspen 55. I called it an ultra lightweight, but wow, that's out of calibration. No, I'm just kidding. We're good. Zero this out. We're at 0. Let's see what we got here. 1 pound, 6 ounces. 1.60 in Marimont. And let's grab a pre-compressed Coleman that I have here. And let's just add this to the list of 4 pounds, 7 ounces, 4.70. And here we go. Here we can see the difference between a few different sleeping bags. We have the standard rectangular sleeping bag by Coleman, great for base camp. 4 pounds, 7 ounces. Can be utilized in multiple ways. You can use it as dogs, for your base camp, for your zipping together to snuggle with your loved one. Kids can have fun with it. Great sleeping bag, great versatility. Kind of a backpacking through camping sleeping bag. I did like it to learn more, but the Kelty tuck at 3 pounds did great. But as you can see in the sizing, it's pretty close to the Coleman. A little bit smaller here now. We have the Cosmic Down, 20-degree sleeping bag by Kelty. Cosmic Down is a great warmth sleeping bag that I can use for all of my backpacking trips, keeping it still light. Next to the summertime trips to the Vermont. Lightest of them all, very compact, very small, very comfortable as well. But again, just gonna choose the right time to use this. And here we have that comparison again between our sleeping bags, size and weight. You just gotta make the right choice for your right adventure. Each sleeping bag offers a great usage for your base camp, maybe your first backpacking trip and you're learning, moving forward with your backpacking trips and then understanding when's the right time to use them. And there's the Zona Camp and Hike miniature perspective on sleeping bags. May not be everything you need to know, but at least it gets you started on your way. I'll see you out there on the trail. Nick with Zona Camp and Hike.